Welcome to this demonstration of ANSA capabilities for watertight model preparation. In this video, we will demonstrate two things. First of all, how to extract and isolate all the exterior wetted surfaces of an automotive geometry, and then how to use Fidelity AutoSeal, which is now integrated inside the ANSA environment, in order to efficiently close all leaks and have a watertight model that can be sent for either surface wrapping or Octree Hextreme volume meshing. For this demonstration, we will use this small vehicle. You will notice that this is a tessellated set of data, it's not CAD. Whenever you input tessellated data in ANSA, either through STL or OBJ format, it's good to check the dimensions and ensure that everything is as expected. So this is 700 units. Remember that by default, the units are defined here in ANSA and are millimeters, unless specified otherwise. So this model is a bit a scale model. We can change this. We can use transform, move, scale, and scale the model in all three directions by 2.5. And now if I make a measurement, you will notice that the wheelbase is approximately the correct one. Now, also something very useful, when you start ANSA, you can go to the CFD meshing profile tool, where you can select your units, again, the application that you have, automotive, specify a characteristic length, in this case, the wheelbase, select the solver and the mesh type. Right? Let's say we go for Hextreme. Pressing apply, ANSA will automatically tune all mesh parameters and quality criteria for that specific application. Now let's investigate our model a bit further. We switch to PID view mode. You will notice that the model consists of different PIDs, which are listed in the PID list. And if we create a cut plane to see inside, we put it in a new part in the model browser. You will notice that it contains a lot of stuff inside, right? Which, if we want to do an external aero simulation, we don't need. I deactivate the cut plane. So how can we quickly isolate the exterior wetted surfaces? We can use the function isolate visibility groups with the option scan all around, right? This means that ANSA will examine the model from all possible view angles and mark if something is visible or not, right? This marking can be done per entity, per element, per macro area, per face, or per property. In this case, we will select to do this per property, right? So that we isolate a complete PID. We can mark if we want to classify groups by average or outermost. In this case, we will select outermost because we want to keep a PID even if a small portion of it is visible on the outside, right? We don't want to lose something that is even partially visible. This is the number of zones that will be displayed in the list that you will see next. And here is a percentage of visibility score, let's say, right? So anything that scores at least 6% visible from all angles means that it will be characterized as fully exterior. Let's press OK. The function runs quite fast. OK, and now ANSA has provided this list window where it marks all the absolutely exterior, which means they have been seen by at least 6% of the different view angles. And we have the absolutely interior, which are components that have not been seen by any view angle. And then we have some components that are partially seen, right? Because in fact, even these things are inside. If I exit the window, you will notice that this model is far from watertight. So it has many leaks and big ones that can see inside the model. For example, these, all the panel gaps, these gaps, and a very big gap here at the rear, right? So we can run the function again. This time increasing, let's say, the value, so that something has to be seen at least by 15% to be characterized as fully exterior. So now we have again our fully interior parts are partially seen or not, and then are fully exterior, right? So in this case, I can select these two groups, right click, show only, and see that they are indeed internal parts, and I can right click and delete these entities. I press all, I have my model, I bring my cut plane again, and you see now that I have kept just the outer shell. Now, we can switch to the next step, which means we want now to identify all these leaks, which are everywhere in this model, and close them in a nice and quick way. And for this, we'll go to Surface Mesh, Auto Seal. Right, this is the function Fidelity Auto Seal integrated inside ANSA. Here you can specify what you want to keep. This means outer or seed points. Just to clarify something, seed points are the so-called wet points, are locations in space where the flow will go and the volume mesh needs to go as well, whereas leak points are dry points and are areas where we don't want the volume mesh to go because the flow will not be there. Now, we can either specify that we want the outer volume, and in this case, we do not need to specify seed points because ANSA knows which is the far field. We only need to specify leak points, right? To specify leak points, we can press this button to pick from the screen. I can pick somewhere on the surface here. Notice in ANSA that when you press Control and left mouse button, you rotate like that. But when you press Control, Shift and rotate, this is so-called dynamic rotation. Shadow is deactivated and you can see better, right, inside. So I pick this point and then I pick the opposite one. And then ANSA will pick the center of gravity of my selected points, right? I can pick a third point and then move this to the center of gravity. So this is one leak point. If I want, I can add more. Here, because this is an easy case, we don't need many leak points. One would have been enough, but let's say we put two. The next thing we need to do is to specify our minimum leak size that we want to keep to close, let's say 2 millimeters. Having specified these few parameters, I can press OK. And now Auto Seal will take place and it will fill, identify all the leak locations and close them with high quality mesh patches. This is a very efficient process. It takes from a few minutes to something like around an hour, even for the most complicated geometries, real automotive complex geometries with underhood details and everything. Okay, so the process completed. Let's examine the result. We can zoom in at the areas that we knew that the leaks were present. You will see that high quality mesh patches have been created to close the geometry in a very nice way, very smooth, all around. And also this big hole here was closed very nicely. In addition, the patches that are created are automatically assigned to the neighboring property, right? So as not to create new patches, but keep the existing PIDs of your CFD model. Of course, if you want to isolate these the created patches, ANSA stores them in a set here. And you can see where they are and you can right click, show only. right, to see the specific patches that were created. Now this model is watertight and can be sent to for surface wrapping or extreme volume meshing. One last thing that I may need to describe here is that in the AutoSeal window you notice an option, push closing towards seed points, the wet points, the exterior, or leak points, the interior. Right? In this case we had seed points, so our patches are created flush on the outside, on the external surface, right? So the groove is not shown anymore. If you want to compare the result with the other option, I can merge in this file. I can use load as a new model in a new window. Right? And I can compare the result of closing the patches inwards towards the leak points inside or outwards towards the seed points. Right? And this applies for all these areas here. This completes the demonstration. Thanks for watching.